Hello, welcome, Chris. Welcome, Border. Borderline, how you doing? Welcome, guys. So the record we got to beat today, well, we're not beating it today. It's impossible to beat it today. But the record is 520. That'll take, if I did 8 hours every day, 4 more days, I reckon. I reckon 4 days. Doesn't really matter when we do it. All that matters is if we do it. You know what I mean? I reckon I could do it in 24 hours, yeah. But I'm not really that motivated to go longer than 8 hours. This game stresses me out. It's always good to be good. It's more than likely my shooting button will actually, it'll break. By the time we've done this, mate, my controller would be broken by then. I stopped shooting, oh my god. All hell breaks loose. Thank you. Hi, Cotton. Dennis. Hello, hello. A 7 minute wave. Timed it. It's all right, isn't it? Around about seven. Three waves every 20 minutes. Nine waves an hour. Plus the added wave every 10 waves, which is the boomer wave, which we're on now. 10 waves an hour. If it's 10 waves an hour, then it takes 2 hours to get to 300. Yeah, you are looking at 24 hours away, exactly, to 5:20. Pretty much, yeah, 24 hours away. It's been a long time. I miss you, my friend. Tell me all about it, and I'll see you again. What gun's better than this? I disagree. I'd probably die with a shotgun. The shotgun has higher DPS, probably. But we're not after DPS, what we're after is multiple kills at once. What I'm looking for is splash damage, the radius of the surface area that the explosions hit the targets. It takes probably a couple of shots to kill a zombie, not the one shot. But the shotgun doesn't have splash damage. The radius of it wouldn't compete against this. I could take out an entire room with a couple of bullets. And even if I fire the one bullet, it stuns the zombies. Doesn't kill them off the one bullet, but it stuns them, so they don't even hit me. All I have to do is fire once, and I have the ability to reload without them hitting me, because it stuns the every zombie in the area. A shotgun doesn't stun the zombie when you shoot him. Shotgun, I wouldn't have time to reload. They'd hoard me, because I wouldn't have the ability to stun. La 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 la. I've tried high rounds with a shotty, and trust me, I've done much worse, but that's just me. People might play better with a shotgun, who knows? But all I know is the person who's got the highest wave in the world, there's only one person that's reached 700 in the world on this game, and they use a grenade launcher. So all I'm doing is pretty much imitating the master. But yeah, shotgun's definitely amazing, and I'm definitely a lot better for the elites, for this red witch here that shoots the balls at me. Shotgun's definitely great for her. Takes ages for a grenade launcher. So when I've got the grenade launcher and I'm shooting her, I'm not really focusing her, I'm just focusing the zombies, pretending that she doesn't exist until she's dead. Like that. I forget she even exists, and I kind of ignore her. Let the splash damage deal with her whilst I'm focusing on the zombies. Doing two birds with one stone still. Whoa! Nearly died there. Thought of everything when it comes to getting to the high waves as best as possible and as quick as possible, and this is the only option. What I've got now, my setup is the best setup going, like when it comes to speed and safety. You want to be safe more than anything, but you want to get to high waves quick as possible, and the grenade launcher provides that safety with the stun ability, the ability to stun. I can just run over here, shoot once here, stuns the zombies around me, grab the ammo. I don't even have to use my ability. I only use my ability just before I'm about to go down. Just, you know, only play it for safety reasons. When you, it's getting to the point where I'm preserving my energy. I want to do this as easy as possible, so I could just sit in a corner, not even have to worry where I'm aiming, and just fire at the floor. It makes the game a bit more easier for me as well. I want to provide the easiest way to get to high waves as well, because when you're going into the high waves, you'll get to a point where you just can't be arsed. You just want to make it easy for yourself. Because how long it's taken, people just get bored and... If you think about it, longevity, if I've got a shotgun, I'll have to be precise in my hits, and I can't be off doing that 24-7, being precise and aiming individually at each zombie coming at me. it requires too much effort, and it's effort I don't want to do when I'm going to be in the game for 200 hours. I'm just making it harder for myself. I don't know, that's just me. That's just me. I'm just lazy. La 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 la. La la la. Instant kill. It's all right, ain't it? Hello, my friend Nick. Welcome, my friend. There's loads of more games on PC, isn't there? For me, I wish I could go to full PC gaming. I'm not gonna lie, but it's the money for me. To buy a proper sexy gaming PC, it's a lot of money. But yeah, PC games are the best, aren't they? They've got everything. They've got all the Xbox exclusives on them. Do you know what I mean? You're not missing out. Welcome, Eddie. And when you get a good one, the graphics look amazing. You can choose the frame rate you want. It's great. Thank you for the shares, mate. Once again, Edward, thank you, mate. Yeah, bloody hell. Yeah. $3,000. Yeah, it's a lot. Bloody hell. When it gets that ridiculous and that expensive, you have to build one, don't you? You gotta build it yourself, just to save money. And to learn the process of it as well. Just by building yourself, you're saving yourself an extra grand and a half, aren't you? I'd say what consoles are good for, though. I'm not afraid to leave the console on and because I'm on the Xbox Series S, you see. I'm not afraid to leave the Xbox Series S on for hours and hours on an end and force and overheat the unit on a zombie game. I'm not afraid to do that because how cheap the unit is. Whereas if I had let's say, $5,000 PC, and I'd be afraid to leave it on for ages. Smashing a game, like let's say if I'm going for wave 500, like what I'm doing now, I'm afraid to do that with an expensive unit because I wouldn't want to overheat it. But saying that, the unit could probably take it, couldn't it? Because I'll so when it comes to zombie games, I If you've noticed as well, all the top players in the world have used a PlayStation to get their high records, to get their world records, and not the PCs. It's like, I don't know. They've all done it on console. That might be because they may be afraid to overheat the PCs. I don't know. Don't really know. Yeah, it doesn't bother me about overheating the Xbox Series S and gaming on it for hours and hours because how cheap it is, it's a great deal. I'd say that's the only positive. It's good value for the money. Yeah, it's I think it's a loyalty thing, that, Edward, isn't it? That's how loyal you are. It's hard to let go of something you've been on forever. Because of loyalty. Makes you feel a bit homesick if you play on a different system. $520 at the minute, Ashley. Mr. Ashley Beck, $520. You're looking at 20... We're 20 hours gameplay away to get there. 20 hours gameplay. I'm going to say about 22 hours. Mad, innit? It's mental. Mental oriental. I want to push myself today and do more than 8 hours. Because I'm sick of being in this game. I want to get it quick as possible. That's if I don't die. You never know, I could die. You never know. That's the beauty of it. Ooh, I found a better way to cancel the animation. That's amazing. Instead of running forward, you just push down the run forward button. Instead of, you don't even have to run forward. Oh, that's cool. The melee animation takes too long, though. Used to run forward like that. You don't need to. There we go, next wave. If I had $4,000, if I had $4,000 right in front of me, I wouldn't actually buy a PC. I'd probably get my teeth. I'd probably buy fake teeth and get like a full set of proper white fake teeth. You know what I mean? Like what these celebrities do. I'd probably buy like implants for my mouth and just have fake teeth. It's either that or a gaming PC. I'm not deciding. La 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 la. Let's get out. Nearly at 300. There's the witch. Thank you. I've got a covenant on that damages zombies near me. Like the that middle covenant. It damages any zombie that's near me. And that helps massively with them elites. Like it damages them constantly. Especially that that red witch. Because my grenade launcher doesn't do a lot of damage, but that contributes a bit towards her. Which does help kill her. Hello, Luke. How you doing, mate? You alright? Doesn't do a lot, though. Hello, Nova. Welcome. I reckon if I look away. I don't know. It's all right with a grenade launcher. You can just shoot the ground and it just kills everything in front of you. It just makes it a bit easier. The only difficult bit is killing the elites and getting ammo. When you run out of ammo, you just gotta grab it from the ammo stack over there, but it's alright to be fair. I haven't found a better spot on the map to actually get through the waves quicker than. I do believe this is the best spot for Shinonuma to blitz through the waves. You need to find a spot that has like an ammo stash, you know, one of these here. That's all you need, really. You don't even need to go and grab shields, to be fair, because how many shields drop by the zombies is unreal. You pretty much have unlimited shields. Got like free armor vests over here, it's brilliant. Yeah, I would say that's the only difficult bit. I wouldn't say I'm the GOAT. I haven't earned that title, to be fair. I've not earned that. There's a lot more better zombie creators out there that play it more than me. La 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 la. What did you say? I'd love to bump into a real zombie and fight it and fight with it. Yeah. You might get bit. So just be careful. Okay? Just make sure not to get bit. Because you never know, you might turn into one. Definitely wear protection. Definitely don't go in without protection. How you doing, Gaz, mate? since the stream started, I think we've gone on seven waves, roughly, I reckon. I don't actually know. Gone quite quick. I tried when I went this morning, I tried to do a couple of waves and I couldn't do it. I get bored. I can only do this if I'm streaming. Can't do it when I'm offline. God, it drags. It's horrible. I don't know how these content creators do it offline and not streaming. A shield. There we go. You gotta be careful knowing this information, Nick. You gotta be very careful that the government isn't on your case, because that's like, knowing that is like secret stuff, you know what I mean? Like, you're onto something here. So make sure, like, there's the FBI don't knock on your door. And make sure to use a VPN when you're online so no one finds out where you live and that, because you finding this information out, mate. It's big stuff. Like knowing what's in Area 51. I've always said this though, I don't think it's aliens that will destroy the Earth. We will destroy the Earth. No alien. We will. We are our own enemy. Yeah. There we go. 14 more, eh? Let's get it. Really, we're basically the Earth's parasite. and Earth's literally trying to get rid of us and kick us off it, because with the tsunamis and the horrible hurricanes and weather and the earthquakes. It's like Earth fighting back, innit? It's like, get off me, you evil parasite. Get off my land. Literally, Earth is just literally trying to kick us out. Yeah, it's horrible, innit, what's happening in Turkey. That's horrible. I saw it on the news. That is... I feel really sorry for them, bad for them, what they have to experience. Frightening, innit? That could happen anywhere in the world, man. It's, they say it's happening in Turkey only because of the, tectonic plates. Turkey's literally right on a tectonic plate, and it's... And it's massive for seismic activity. It's like the worst place to live on the Earth for seismic activity. It's constantly active. I'm really hungry. Do I got chills, they're multiplying. Mate, literally. This is gonna take ages. I can see this now, I think. I might stop at like 521. We'll see how I feel. I might keep going up. Another grenade launcher here, look. Is it? I didn't realise I had that. It's mad. Yo, KD baby, what's up, my man? Behaving yourself. I got one more. Boom. Streams have been alright. But how am I? I feel like I'm slowly turning into a zombie. That's how I feel today. Like, now and then you might hear me go, and speak like a zombie because of how long I've been in this game. But apart from that, I feel quite good. How are you feeling, mate? Whoa. That caught me off guard, that. That's horrible hearing that. You haven't heard earthquakes. That's horrible. It's a good thing the house ain't damaged then, innit? But yeah, that's horrible, huh? I don't think where I live we ever had an earthquake, to be fair. We're quite lucky. I've never experienced an earthquake in the UK. It's never happened. Yeah, 288. So basically, last time I didn't really properly go for the record, to be fair. I felt like I never properly went for it. Because I never really paused it and came back to it. I just usually don't pause the game and never go back to it. So last time I never properly went for it. But this time I am. Because I'm going out of my way to play offline and also pause the game. So the online servers don't kick me off. So we're kind of this time round a bit more prepared to face the inevitable. put it this way, I've never been this high on a zombie game. On this game, anyway. I've never been this high on Vanguard. On Cold War, my highest is 456 on Cold War. But I was playing the online, I was playing on the online servers and it kicked me offline. So, because on Cold War, I might attempt Cold War and play offline on Cold War. I might attempt it and see how well I do. We'll see. Might give Cold War a second chance and a second go and get to 935 on each map after I've done with this game. Once I get every record on every map on this game, I will attempt Cold War. But Cold War's the game's more likely to crash on Cold War. So that's what I got to take into account. Crashes will be a thing. See you later, Nick, mate. Have a good day. See you later, my man. What do you mean? It should be a lot more than that, shouldn't it? You made a new profile, didn't you? I think. I don't remember. You'd have had loads of profiles. La 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 la. Next wave. God, it's gonna take ages, isn't it? Look at that. Eleven more to go. Octane Bertie, Xbox. Xbox gamer, baby. You on Xbox, Mario? I'm only on the one. I'm not that privileged. La 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 la. Here we go. We're nearly at 100k kills. Bruh. Can't wait to reach my 300 mark. I've never been 300 on this game. Never done it. Never thought it was possible, but here we are. Somehow we're doing it. Say one good thing about Vanguard, and that is the minimap top left. I just find it so much more easy to play knowing where the zombies are. Like 24/7. Now, if all I could literally keep playing the game if I just look at the minimap only. I don't actually have to look it right in front of me. I could just literally just stare at the minimap and just look for the red dots. And shoot the floor. I could also go out there and grab ammo as well. It's like playing Asteroid. Cold War did have a minimap, but it didn't have the red dots on it 24/7 to this extent. The Adam appearing ever so often. knew that nearly killed me doing that. Because I didn't even get the ammo. Yeah, Geo mate, just chilling, mate. How are you doing? Not much, really. Just bit of Vanguard. The record for this map is 520. Not far off, are we? About 20 hours in. 19 hours. 20 hours, I don't know. I reckon we're about 20 hours away, so we're technically halfway, kind of. I've got another 20 hours to get there. I reckon a good 3 days. 3 days away with 8 hours each. I could do it in 2 days if I smash 12-hour days, but nah, we're not doing that. I've not tried Hogwarts, I don't have the money for it now. I can't afford it. La 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 la. They nearly trapped me there, didn't they? Hey, King Cow. King Cow. Mr. Cow Richie. You don't mind the nickname Richie, do you? Mr. Richie. Mr. Cow. Not seen you in ages, bro. How you been? Why? One sec. A lot of English people. Oh, yeah. There's a lot of people in England called Richie. I know. I literally probably know 7 Richies. I've been across a few people called Richie, you know, probably like seven or eight. Mate, Fall Guys is addictive. I've played that. I've had a few wins on it. I've not played it in ages though. Not played it in ages. I don't even know what they've added. Do they add like new maps every season? Like new obstacle courses? Yeah, I've not. I only played it when it first came out on Xbox, and then stopped playing it. Massive and crazy how popular that game is. Bloody hell! Yeah, that's it, isn't it? Yeah, that's it. Crowns. 1,300. That is a bit. It's a bit extreme, that, isn't it? Alright, this game's broken, bro. This game's absolutely broken. It's not letting me grab my ammo. You are classed as a level 2 sweat. That's what you are. 2.0 sweaty crown master. That's your title. I know a kid who streams who absolutely smashes that game. He blew up on TikTok. He's got really long hair and curly hair. La 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 la. Evil. It's not free, no, it's, you have to pay for it. Unfortunately, you have to pay for every Call of Duty title, apart from the Warzone games. Yeah, I wish they gave them out for free, that'd be great, wouldn't it? Maybe one day they'll make the games for free, because they make enough money anyway. Black Ops Games is due soon, isn't it? I don't know. I've not been paying attention, to be fair. Well, what have you heard? Which Black Ops? The original Black Ops, Kyle? The original Black Ops. You know it, Kin. You know it. Zombies is my middle name. I've been in this game of zombies for about 20 hours now. This has been a 20-hour game. I believe, I'm not too sure. I lost count after 1 hour. I'm just making it up now as I go along, like how long I've been in this game. I've always been bad at math. But we're about 20 hours away. I reckon it's going to be about a 40-hour game to get the world record. You're looking at around about 40 hours to get to wave 520. That's the goal. But we're not going to stop at 520. We're going to keep going on and on and on. Touch wood. Hope we don't lag out. But yeah, I want to beat 520. It's possible. Maybe. I figured out a way to pause the game, go off the game, go on another game. Yeah. Go on another game. Okay, we're on another game now. Go off that game and go back on that game. You know, it doesn't just do that as well. I found a way to actually also turn my console off. And turn it back on again, and we're still in the game. So that is what we're dealing with here. Found a way on Xbox to log off from the online servers, so I'm not online anymore, I'm offline. My internet could disconnect and we're still chilling. We're chilling. My console can turn off, we're chilling. The only way this isn't gonna happen is if I die. Now, the only way that's going to kill me is if my cockiness is going to get me down. But as it stands, I'm not going to die. We just got to keep touching wood. And we're okay. But yeah, that's... let's hope we can do it this time. It looks like everything's on our side. so to get a disconnection is highly unlikely. I don't know. I don't know how it's going to work. I feel like it is best to not talk about it, because if we talk about it, then it might happen. It is very good to know. It's useful information if you're on Xbox. But, yeah. Thank you, Xbox, for giving me the option to enable quick resume. And having quick resume on games, so you can quick resume a game. It's that quick resume feature, isn't it, that Xbox has. It's a shame that they don't have that feature on Cold War. In order for me to do the Cold War game, I'd have to stay paused and not go off it. I'd have to keep it on pause if I was doing Cold War. I'd have to leave the Xbox on, which is scary because it could overheat if we did it on any other title. How's it going? My first down. I've only had one down. It is possible. I could die. I've had one down. And that was me doing something stupid. I was literally playing without looking at the screen, thinking I could do it. So I lost out on a world record then. Shame. Yeah. I need a wee, one sec.
Don't you forget about me.
Yeah,